Welcome to yoga session. Keep standing in comfortable way. Close your eyes. You concentrate exactly at the midpoint of your both eyebrows. In yoga, it is called Bhru Madhya. Keep exhaling. And while exhaling, resolve that I am expelling out all the toxins, all the diseases and all the impurities out in my head cavity. While inhaling, resolve that I am nourishing all the cells in my head cavity. This resolution is much important, because as we resolve, our brain starts secreting such kind of chemicals and which helps us to boost our immunity as well as to maintain good health. So while exhaling and inhaling, our mind should be focused in that particular area. And you think in such a way, you resolve. Now you concentrate at the center of your heart, the very midpoint of our body. Keep exhaling as if you are exhaling right from the center of our heart. And resolve that I am expelling out all the impurities, all the diseases in my chest cavity. While inhaling, resolve I am nourishing all the parts, all the cells in my chest cavity. Now repeat same kind of resolution and breathing while focusing in a navel center, belly button. So here we have to resolve for the abdominal cavity and the legs. The thought is much more important than what we do. Both the things should go together. It should not be only a physical activity. Our mind should be clubbed with the physical activities. Now we shall pray. So adopt Namaskar Mudra. Close your eyes. So this is a sincere salutation to Patanjali. Let's pray together. Yogena Chittasya Padena Vacham मलं शरीरस्य च वैद्यकेन योपाकरोतं प्रवरं मुनीनां पतञ्जलिं प्राञ्जलिरानतोऽस्मि गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुः साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः. नाउ लेट्स बिगिन विथ सम सिंपल वार्मिंग अप एक्सरसाइजेस. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फोल्ड योर बोथ आर्म्स ओवर अ बैक. सो ट्राई टू ग्रास्प द आउटर एज ऑफ योर एल्बोस. स्टैंड स्ट्रेट. नाउ लोअर डाउन योर चिन फर्स्ट. Press it against the chest. Now while inhaling, raise your head. Let your chin be pointing upward towards the ceiling. Now again lower it down. 1, 2. While inhaling, raise your chin. 3. Four, five,
six, seven. Now look straight. Twist your chin to right first, one. Now to left, two. Three, again right, four, five, six, and now looks straight. Okay, so we shall have the shoulder rotation. First, hold your shoulders properly. Now pull down your elbows close to your rib cage. Lower down your elbows. Okay. Now let's have a rotation, full rotation. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Now in a opposite direction. 1 2 3 4 5 6 and 7. Okay, now we shall have a side bending. So first of all, raise your both arms upward. Now lock your fingers, keep your palms facing upward. Now stretch the whole trunk to maximum, hold it, close your eyes. Now have a good deep in breath followed by long exhalation. Okay, now once you inhale a deep, and while exhaling bend towards right without bending the elbows. Your both elbows must be very straight and the upper shoulder is pushed backward. See, your whole body should be in a one line. You should not tilt either forward or backward, and both the elbows are straight. Hold this 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and 10. Now stand straight again. Once have a good deep in breath, and while exhaling bend towards left. Be comfortable, push your upper shoulder as backward as possible. Both the elbows must be very straight, both knees are very straight. Hold it 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. Now stand straight. Now let's have this same in a rapid way. First to right and then left. 1 2 3 4. See, your elbows are very straight. 5 6 7 8. Relax. Now we shall have a little twisting. So keep your legs about 3 to 4 feet away. Now pull your both palms close to your chin, and both the elbows, they are facing outward. Don't lock the fingers. Let be comfortable. Don't stretch it, be comfortable. Okay, now stretch your right arm towards right side. Open it, stretch it. Now keep looking to your right palm and slowly twist to your right to maximum. Whatever possible, you keep twisting to right. At the same time, you have to push the left elbow as backward as possible. Okay, and now see, both the toes, they are properly pointing forward, and the outer edge of both feet should be pressed on the ground properly. You are standing straight. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and 10. Now look straight. close the right elbow and open the left arm. Now look at the left palm and keep twisting towards left. Push your right shoulder backward. Hold it. Both the knees are very straight. Don't tilt either to right or left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay. Now the same thing we shall have in a rapid way. First to right and then left. 1, right. Keep looking at the palm. 2, left. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and relax. Relax. You can bring your legs closer, be comfortable. You can move your legs in whatever fashion you like. You can keep walking or whatever you like. You can just relax your toes and calves.
Okay. Now we shall have little knee rotation. Keep your legs about a foot away. Now place your both palms over the knees. Yes, and just keep have a circular movement of the knees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now in opposite direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So today we are going to perform Surya Namaskar. So initially for some people it might be difficult to perform all postures in a proper way. So first let's see how to perform the whole sequence of postures in Surya Namaskar. So let's have a look. One Surya Namaskar. Keeping both toes and heels together, stand straight. First adopt a Namaskar mudra. Push your elbows and shoulders backward. Look straight. Your chest muscles should be expanded. Both the elbows should be lined with each other. Okay. Now inhaling, raise your both arms. So maintaining the Namaskar mudra, you have to raise the arms and then just bend backward as much as possible. Hold it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is the posture number 1. Now 2, bend forward. Now try to catch hold the toes first, then slowly lower down your head and place your both palms close to your both heels, and knees must be very straight. Now stretch out the right leg backward, raising head. Try to lower down your trunk. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now 4, both legs together, whole body in a plank posture, straight line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Next posture is very important. Both knees, they are touching ground, then chest, and then the forehead and both palms. So this is Sashtanga Namaskar. 8 body parts, they are touching the ground, and this is the surrendering posture. Very important posture in Surya Namaskar. Both toes, both knees, both palms, chest and forehead. Now just raise your head a little. See how he is performing. You have to stretch the whole trunk forward, slide it ahead. Now your toes will be pointing backward automatically, and then raise your whole body forward. Now push the head backward. This is Bhujangasana. Both thighs, they are touching the ground, and chest is expanded. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. 7. Posture number 7, Adho Mukha Svanasana.
you can walk little ahead to place the both heels on the ground. They must be touching the ground. Both knees are very straight, and lower down your head to maximum 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now the right leg again forward in between both palms, and your chin is pointing upward. Posture number 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now bring your both legs together. Posture number 9. And forehead close to the knees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then, no, okay. Just bring your both palms over the chest. So this is the whole sequence of Surya Namaskar. Now, all of us, we shall practice this together, 3 Surya Namaskars. So, bring your both legs together, both toes, heels, knees, they are touching to each other. The right way to perform Surya Namaskar is to recall or surrender to Surya, Sun. So, now lead and follow. I'll chant one name, you are supposed to follow me. Om Mitraya Namaha.
Om Mitraya Namaha.
One, inhale, raising arm, bend backward. Two, exhaling, bend forward, bring your palms close to your heels. Three, stretch out the right leg while inhaling. 4, hold the breath, both whole body in a plank way. 5, exhale, knees, chest and forehead. 6, inhaling, raise your whole trunk upward, Bhujangasana. 7, Adhomukha Svanasana, lower down your head. 8, 9, again exhale and stand straight in Namaskar Mudra. 10, Om Ravaye Namaha. 1, inhale. 2, exhale, bend forward. 3, inhale. 4, hold the breath. 5, exhale. 6, inhale. 7, exhale. 8, inhale. 9, exhale. 10, inhale. Om Bhanave Namaha.
Om Bhanave Namaha.
1, inhale. 2, exhale out. 3, inhale. 4, hold it, hold the breath. 5, exhale. 6, inhale. 7, exhale. 8, 9, 10, relax. Okay, now you can relax your legs, arms in whatever fashion you like. You can shake your arms, and just keep walking a little. And then sit down. Yes. Okay, now sit down. In any comfortable way. And just be watchful of your breath. Thank you.
So today we are performing some postures for having a good digestion, because nowadays many people we suffer indigestion problem. So today's sequence will be focused for good digestion. So first, extend your both legs, sit in a comfortable way. Now you keep your both legs about a foot away and try to hold your both toes in whatever comfortable way. So don't tax your body. If you are not able to hold your toes, you can hold your both ankles, but knees should be straight. Okay, now look at your right palm and just stretch out your right arm towards right side, and following your palm you have to twist to right to maximum. Now your left palm is over the right toe. Bring your left palm over the right toe and hold it. Now be watchful of your breath. You just have deep in breath followed by long exhalation. Okay, and now bring your right arm in front, and then in same way you have to twist to left. So following your left palm, twist towards left side. Twice you have a good long inhalation and exhalation. Keep your both knees very straight. You can hold your ankle if you like, if it's difficult to hold the toe. Okay, now same activity we shall perform in a rapid way. So first to right, one, inhale, exhale, both arms in front. Now inhaling, twist to left, three, four, one, two, exhale, three, inhale, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, and relax. So be in a relaxed way. You can rest over the palms. So the posture we are performing is Vakrasana. First have a look how to perform this. You are supposed to raise either leg and hold it with the opposite palm and twist to side. So let's see. Bring your both toes first together. Now grasp your right heel, the outer edge of your right foot, with left palm, and slowly raise the right leg. So the whole body should be very straight. And now stretch out your right arm sideways. Keep looking to the right palm and push your both shoulders as backward as possible. Hold it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Relax. So let's begin with performing this posture in a formal way. First you fold your right leg. Fold your right leg. Okay. Now twist your trunk to right to maximum. Hold it for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now try to grasp the right heel or the outer edge with left palm, and resting over the right palm, you have to raise the right leg. First raise it. Hold it for a while. See, the right knee is very straight. Now if it's not possible to raise the leg in a straight way, if the knee is not getting straightened, then again you can hold your ankle. Hold it. The lower edge of your ankle. And then stretch out the right arm. Okay. So don't rest backward.
keep straight, hold it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now bring your right arm forward, slowly bend the right leg and relax. This is called Vakrasana, a twisting posture. A good posture to improve the digestion as well as strengthening the calf and thigh muscles and also our back muscles, tuning whole vertebral column. Now the same posture, begin on the other side. First fold the left leg. Okay, now twist to left in whatever fashion you like. You can keep resting on the left palm. Push the left shoulder as backward as possible. Hold it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now try to hold the outer edge of your right foot and slowly raise the right leg. So first hold it. See, the leg must be very straight. You are not allowed to bend the knee. It's mandatory. The leg should be straight. Hold it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And slowly raise your left arm and keep it straight. Push it as backward as possible. Hold it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Relax. Okay, we shall have a very comfortable posture. Just for a change, that is Purvottanasana. So keep your both palms backward. Now keep resting on your palms, fold to your both knees. See, your legs are little apart, but the both knees are closer to each other. And now raising your chin upward, slowly raise the whole body upward. So it is like a plank posture in an opposite way, half way Purvottanasana, Ardha Purvottanasana. Hold it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and slowly sit down. Okay. Now you just stretch your both arms in front and lock your fingers. Keep your palms pressing straight. Don't extend the legs. The knees should be in the same way. And just push your whole trunk as forward as possible. Hold it as if someone is stretching you. So we are squeezing the whole abdominal cavity and the thighs. Hold it. Try to keep your knees together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now again resting backward, place your both palms on the ground and perform Ardha Purvottanasana. Hold it. Knees pointing inward and both legs are little away. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again sit down and stretch your both arms forward. Hold it. Try to bring your chin close to the knees. You can keep your chin against the knees if it's possible. Both the knees are together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now one more round. Again, Ardha Purvottanasana. raise your head, keep your chin pointing backward. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. And now again stretch the both arms forward, hold it. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. Right from here only we are going to perform Pavana Muktasana. So you fold your both elbows, pull your both legs close to body, and then hold your elbows around the knees and try to sit as straight as possible. So stretch the whole vertebral column, try to sit as tall as possible. Both knees are together. Initially, for many people it may not be possible to hold the elbows, so initially you can keep your knees little away and try to hold your wrist. So especially those are having a little bulged belly and fat, so make yourself comfortable and gradually you try to keep bringing your palms close to the elbows slowly and try to hold the outer edge of your elbows. Now close your eyes, inhale, and while exhaling low down your head as to touch your chin against the knee. Exhaling, bring the chin over the knees. Now inhaling, raise your head, sit straight. 2 3, low down the chin. 4 5 6 7, and hold it. Try to pull your heels closer. Pavana Muktasana in a sitting way. Now here you have to exhale, focus on exhaling. Try to exhale as longer, longer and longer. Extend your exhalation. Those who wish to overrule the indigestion, then piles, constipation, acidity problems, and whatever, the irregular digestion, or even loss of appetite, all these things you can overrule by performing this posture. But one has to hold it at least for about a minute. Now slowly raise your chin and sit in a relaxed fashion. Next is Dhanurasana, bow posture. Let's have a look how to perform it. First, you have to lie down over stomach, then folding both legs, you try to grasp the ankles, respective ankles, and raise the whole body from both ends. So this is what Dhanurasana is. Hold it. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. Okay, relax. And now all of us, we shall perform together. So first of all, lie down in a comfortable way. Okay, now let's bend the knees one by one. Just bend the knees. 1, bend them one by one. 2 3, try to pull them towards the tailbone. 4, toes pointing towards spine. 5 6 7 8 9 10. Now fold both legs,
you just hold the ankles, hold it, you try to hold it properly. Many times for the beginners it is bit difficult to hold the ankles too. So try in a whatever fashion to hold the both ankles. Now slowly inhale and raise your head a little. First you raise the head, then chest. Okay, now as if someone is pulling you backward, you have to pull your whole body with the help of your legs. So your legs are pulling you backward. Hold it. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 and now slowly raise your legs to maximum as if someone is pulling you upward, and we are going to hold it for about next 25 seconds. Try to be steady. Again keep extending the exhalation. And relax. Okay. We are going to repeat the same repeat Dhanurasana. So again fold your knees. Hold the ankles and close your eyes. First you inhale and try to raise the body from both ends. See your whole balance is over the navel, the belly button. Hold it. Keep extending the exhalation. This is Dhanurasana. Contraction of the lower back. Expanding the chest muscles. Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it. 10 9 8 7 6 5 3 2 1 and relax. Okay, the last posture is Jathara Parivartanasana. That is a twisting posture. So you just roll over a back. Now the last posture is Jathara Parivartanasana, that is again a twisting posture. So let's have a look how to perform this. Just bring your both palms below the head. Now fold your knees over the chest and just lower down your knees towards left side of the body and twist your chin to right. So this is the posture. So let's all of us, we shall start doing this. Lie down, bring your both palms just below the head first. Lock your fingers, both elbows, they are properly touching the ground, and slowly fold your knees over the chest. Hold it. So keep exhaling out. Let the whole abs get squeezed properly. You try to extend the exhalation longer and longer. Now press your both knees against each other. Both knees should be properly touching each other. Once inhale,
and while exhaling slowly lower down your knees towards left side. So this is a twisting Jathara Parivartanasana. Initially it may not be possible for you to do this much of twisting, so make yourself comfortable, but see the both elbows, they are touching the ground, so don't raise the right elbow. Generally the newcomers, they, when the knees are touching the ground, automatically the right elbow gets raised. So take care of your right elbow. Slowly keep looking towards right, twist your chin to right, hold it 10 9 8 7 6 5 3 2 1 and slowly raise your knees, pull them close to the chest and relax your legs. Okay, now the same to the other side. So keep your palms just below the head as they were and pull the knees close to the chest again. While exhaling, hold it for a while. Always, whatever the posture we are doing, you focus on exhalation. So if you exhale longer, then it becomes easier to move towards the next step. Now again inhale, and while exhaling just lower down your both legs towards right side. For those, if it is much comfortable to place the right knee touching the ground, the left knee close to the right, both knees are together, see your left elbow, it is properly touching the ground. Now keep looking towards your right elbow, twist your chin properly, hold it. This is Jathara Parivartanasana, squeezing the abdominal cavity. 10 9 8 7 6 5 3 2 1 and slowly you can stretch the legs. First you raise your legs and then extend them and relax. Shavasana. During practicing Shavasana, we have to relax all muscles and all body parts which we employed during this session. So just recall, what did we do? Initially we had shoulder rotation. So what kind of stretch or what kind of strain you experienced during the shoulder rotation, neck movements, and focus on those particular parts, shoulders, back of the neck, and then slowly relax them.
then we had twisting. We twisted when the legs were about 3 feet away. So you try to recall what kind of stretch was there at the inner edge of your thighs, and you were twisting, you were squeezing your abdominal muscle. Now focus on all those muscles and relax them. Then we did Surya Namaskar. In Surya Namaskar, one position we bend backward, then next to it we bend forward, again backward bending, then the plank posture, then Sashtanga Namaskar, further to it is Bhujangasana, followed by Adhomukha Svanasana, that is Samit posture. So we lower down the head and the heels, they are touching the ground. Then number 9 posture, Ashvasanchalana. One leg is in between both palms and other is extended backward. Then standing straight with legs together, it is a forward bending, and again we are standing straight. So you please recall the whole sequence of Surya Namaskar and what kind of strength or what kind of stretch you experienced during the whole sequence, and focus on those muscles, those body parts, and again relax them. You just imagine that your body is like a jelly, and when the jelly is in a freeze, it gets contracted, its size is reduced, and when you just put it into your dish, it starts spreading out. So in the same way, your muscles, your all body parts, they are just relaxing, they are spreading away. All the muscle tissues, they are getting apart from one to other. You are losing the muscles. Then next to Surya Namaskar, we did the Vakrasana. That is, while sitting, we did twisting and the either leg was raised up to 45 degrees. So a good amount of squeezing to the abdominal muscles, then the vertebral column, and we were extending the arm and pushing it back. So the shoulder muscles, they were contracted. You were using the whole strength of your upper back muscle. So relax them. Both sides, you concentrate at the right shoulder, then left shoulder, and relax it. Further to it was Purvottanasana, and we had a very small duration Pavan Muktasana. So we were sitting and stretching the arms. While that, we were squeezing our abdominal muscles. So you please concentrate there and relax them. Then we did Dhanurasana, bow posture. While lying over a stomach, we raised our body from both ends. So recall what kind of efforts you gave to your body, how you used it, and just relax those all muscles. And lastly, we did Jathara Parivartanasana. That is, lying over a back, we had a twisting. So while doing that twisting, you just remember, how did you do it? How you used your lower back muscles, then chest muscles, how they were squeezed, everything. And just relax all muscles. So when you are relaxing muscles, you try to extend the exhalation. As and when you exhale longer, longer and longer, you will experience that the tendon is like a part of that muscle which get inserts into the bone. So as we have some handle to our bag and we hold that handle, in the same way the tendons, they are like handles of the muscles. So you have to relax the tendons in Shavasana. Now lastly, you just breathe in consciously, you listen to your breath and exhale longer and longer. And here we shall conclude this session. See you in the next session.